I was sitting there looking at the market saying, okay, we're down 3 points for the Dow. How am I going to get this excited? You know, and suddenly we spiked 267 points, Sarge. What was it on the floor?
I'll tell you what, and I want all my little home gamers to get to gather around the TV right now, because when the algos kicked in, when the headline readers kicked in, they took the market up to 2644 in the S&P. That's a 50% retracement of the October through December sell-off. When it came in, they found support where? At 2628. That's the 50-day simple moving average. We are lasered in on the algos, guys. We got them. Get on your E-Trade accounts, get on your Ameritrade accounts, because those guys are watching 13-year-olds crack up on skateboards on YouTube. Mm-hmm. We're working, and we, the humans, can beat the algos today. We got them.
Well, that is a fascinating perspective, because some people feel, Sarge, that the algos, these high-frequency trading operations, are just pressing a button, and that the retail investor can get squashed. But as we look at the Russell, we look at the S&P, Russell is up 9 points. Oil turned around. Gold started to go down. I just think it is very interesting on a day like this that you say that the retail investor can win here, Sarge.
We can beat them. It has to be something you focus on all day. You can't do something else for a living, and then you just have to be an investor. You can't be a trader. But if you're a trader, and sometimes you see how the algos behave, if this 26-28 level, we're only 1 point above it now, holds, then it goes higher. But if it could turn into a pivot. We can go significantly lower. This is where you have to either spin it out on one side or the other. One other thing I want everyone to focus on is the Lunar New Year. It's February 5th.
Yes.
This would be seen by the Chinese people as a tremendous overture if they were throwing an olive branch ahead of that date.
Ah, I like your thinking. Let me get to Larry Shover in Chicago. It is the year of the pig. We know it on Wall Street, and this is their expression on Wall Street, pigs get slaughtered. So, you know, you don't want to be too greedy at a time like this. But, Larry, what are you seeing? Who's buying what at this very moment?
Well, right now it's got a chasey feel to it, if that's even a word. But I think there's a lot of, people just upset that they didn't buy the market when we hit the low in 2350, 2360 area. But I think most of the smart money, some of the institutional money, is thinking that the last 300 points, the market just was in a reset mode. The next 100 points going forward, it's going to be tougher. But most people do believe that the S&P 500, based on earnings, should see 2,700 in the near term, but it's not going to be easy to get there. So there is buying. It's methodical buying, and smart money is doing that right now based on earnings projections.
Speaking of earnings, Phil, we got to talk about the banks here. Morgan Stanley reported it was a disappointment. They're having a little bit of a struggle sort of wrapping their arms around the volatility of the previous quarter here. And you do have Morgan Stanley going lower at the moment. It's been a real checkerboard, I believe, for earnings so far. J.P. Morgan, Goldman Sachs killed it. And, and then you got Bank of America, Citi, all of these names. And this checkerboard has people wondering, do we go into financials?
I think you do. I mean, at the end of the day, the banks that have embraced the new volatility did very well. The other ones that got caught flat-handed on it and didn't adjust to it didn't do very well, as in Morgan Stanley. But if you look at the amount of money that the banks are making right now, it's incredible. And I think that's going to continue. So even though you have one bad quarter of trading and volatility, I think the banks as a sector really, really look solid. And you're in this environment right now where it's the best of both worlds. You've got potentially interest rates that are off the lows. They may not go higher as aggressively as people thought. You've got trading volatility, if done right, can really enhance their earnings. But as a sector, the sector is going to kill it.
Listen, I love you guys. Thank you. On a day where we are seeing some whipping fast movement in the markets, everybody's got to stay with us. Gentlemen, thank you so much.